Welcome to another episode of Adobe Tutorials. For the first step, you'd want to duplicate the target image for backup purposes. And for now, we'd hide that layer and we'd go to the next one. We'll select Filter, go to Distort, and you'll select the wave pattern. You can play around with the sliders until you achieve a desired look. Also, you have to make sure that you have selected square. Once you're happy with it, you can select OK. For the next step, you're gonna duplicate the original image once again and put it on top of the distorted layer. Then we'll add a layer mask to hide some portions of the image we don't want to see in order to show the distorted layer. After that, you'll create a duplicate layer. For a new layer, we'll add another wave distortion effect. So, we'll repeat the same process, but this time we'll use different settings to make a different effect. And for our next step, we'll add the scan lines. So what you do have to do is create a new layer, fill it with white, and then we'll go to filter gallery and we'd look for the halftone pattern setting and select lines. For this part, you can play around with the sliders so you can change the amount and the size of the lines. Once you're happy with it, just go and press OK and go to the blending options. Make sure that you select soft light. You can adjust the impact of the effect through opacity. You can lessen it to show more of the image. You can also add the 3D effect by going into blending options and unchecking G and B under channels of advanced blending. After that, you select the move tool to nudge the image a little bit to the right or to the left to create that 3D image look. And that's how you make the glitch effect.